Have you listened to National Public Radio recently? Now, admittedly, NPR was always a little nutty, but in a familiar, non-threatening kind of way. Your average public radio station ran niche cultural programming most of the time, the Celtic Music Hour or a bluegrass show. In fact, for decades, public radio's most popular feature was something called Car Talk. Remember that? It was a show where two Italian mechanics from Boston, hilarious, both of them, argued about the relative merits of carburetors versus fuel injections. And they gave you free advice on how to fix your Honda. And then in the morning and again at night, as always in drive time, all NPR stations aired the news from Washington. There was Morning Edition in the morning, and there was All Things Considered on the trip home. NPR anchors were left of center, obviously, but more than anything, they were self-consciously upmarket. They spoke in comically stilted voices designed to suggest deep erudition. You can imagine them reading a lot of Rilke in their spare time and having complicated opinions about wine. This is NPR, they'd say, National Public Radio. It was all pretty amusing, easy to mock, but it was basically harmless. NPR didn't call for violent revolution or denounce white people as demons. That did happen on some radical stations like Pacifica, but not at NPR. At NPR, they were just dopey, self-important, 70s-style liberals, the kind with dangly earrings and composting bins in their yards.